I'm really gonna need your help on this one, guys, because I'm kind of stumped, and it's in regards to a secret game mode for MK11. So, of course, what's going on, everybody? My name's Dynasty. What I got for y'all today is another MK11 video, and for sure, there's at least one game mode inside this game that was teased at the MK11 gameplay reveal that we still don't know, and apparently it's gonna blow our minds according to a designer that's currently working at Noob Studios, but I think there's even more than one. I think there's a total of two, and I think I might know what one is, but I don't know what the other is. So with that said, let's break this down and let's get into it. So Danish Saeed, who is a senior UI artist at Noob Studios, a few days ago on Twitter said this right here. Reading all the MK11 reactions have been incredible. Even some of the criticisms have been totally welcome and may inform how the game shapes up. I'm a little shocked nobody asked about a very subtle tease we put in the demo. People will lose their minds when we reveal it. Now, this was just a few days ago. I saw this, a lot of you guys saw this, and I just assumed that he was talking about this right here. Bam! On the second menu tab underneath fight, we have local, tournaments, online, and then three question marks, and I was assuming that he was talking about this game mode where we see these three question marks. And of course, this is where things get interesting, because this appears to be a screenshot of like a modern take on the classic Mortal Kombat 1 arena, the Warrior Shrine, where we see all the characters posing as statues with Goro right in the center. Like, there's no question for sure this is Kano and this is Johnny inside the MK1 Warrior Shrine. So I saw this, I was like, okay, could this be what I think this is? And I got so stoked for it. I still think there is a strong chance. I still think this might be, guys, might be Mortal Kombat 1 HD Remake. Now take this with just a small tiny grain of salt, but just as recent as last year, January 2018, this small team of a few people were putting together an HD remake of Mortal Kombat 1, Mortal Kombat 2, and Mortal Kombat 3. It was so good to the point where even Ed Boon was trying to get WB to let these guys put together this game, and ultimately it didn't happen because WB said that this small team of a few people weren't experienced enough to continue on with the project, and they sent them like a cease and desist, and the project had to come to an end. And this was, like I mentioned, as recent as last January. So just about a year ago, this happened. Now, people have been, you know, speculating for a long time now that, of course, with the release of MK11, there might be the re-release of an HD remake version of the trilogy of Mortal Kombat 1 to 3 games. There's even a company currently working on a 90s fighting game right now, and it's going to be on the Switch, the Xbox One, PC, PS4, etc., but we don't know much details other than the fact that it's going to be like a 90s fighting game. So I still think this might be like an HD remake of Mortal Kombat 1. That's what I'm hoping it is. But then again, it's confirmed that indeed the crypt is coming back. So I can kind of see this being like the Warrior Shrine, maybe like the leaderboards, maybe wait for you to go inside the crypt and see like the shrine of things you can unlock maybe. So that's what I thought that Danish Saeed, this guy at Noob Studios, was teasing with this initial tweet right here. But it turns out this wasn't even the game mode that he was teasing. He was teasing another section from the MK11 demo at the reveal event with, again, question marks. So there's one with question marks that I just showed you, and yet again, there is another with question marks. Now, how do I know he's not talking about the Warrior Shrine section? Well, because just yesterday, he followed up his initial tweet by saying this right here. So my comment above was true when I first tweeted it, but since then, many people have asked about it, and designer Paulo Garcia referenced it in this interview, and of course he linked the Game Crate interview that I've showcased here on my channel the past few days that gave us a ton of news in regards to MK11, and he even gave us an excerpt saying, of course here, they were asking him, so, that's a mode aimed at the single player experience. What else do you have in the game that's aimed at the solo player? And of course, Paulo Garcia said, there's stuff in the demo. The first zone where there's all the single player stuff. There's a fourth option, that's all question marks now, that will be announcing soon. So you're probably scratching your head saying, Dynasty, show me the second section with question marks. Well, here it is. Bam! You got the Conquer section. Story, Towers of Time, Classic Towers, and again, another section with three question marks, and it's driving me nuts because not only do we have the Classic Warrior Shrine with question marks, but a completely different section, also with question marks. Now, through interviews lately, we now know that the Crypt is confirmed to be coming back. There's not going to be a tag team mode. There's not going to be puzzle combat, chess combat, motor combat, anything crazy like that. What could this, you know, single player experience, single player game mode be if it's not the other mini games? If we're going to make an assumption based on the NetherRealm Studios / Midway Games track record, it could be a few things. It could be AI Battle Simulator that was just introduced instead of Injustice 2. It was fun for what it was. It was a single player experience, but is that something that's going to make us lose our minds when it gets revealed? I don't think so. Going back to the 3D era, Mortal Kombat Armageddon had a conquest mode that was based on Shaolin Monks, so maybe it's a side story with a Shaolin Monk style gameplay aspect added to it, because everybody's been in demand for a Shaolin Monks 2. Maybe that could be it. Going back to Deception, we also had Conquest Mode, except at that time, Conquest Mode was more of an RPG, where you'd run around the different realms collecting Kamidogus for Damashii, who ended up being the Dragon King, spoiler alert, hence why the game is called Deception. So, could it be Conquest Mode from Deception? Could it be Conquest Mode from Armageddon? It's kind of like Shaolin Monks. Could it be AI Battle Simulator? Could it be just a brand new mode altogether? It might be that too. Whatever this thing is, it's meant to make us lose our mind when it gets revealed, and that has me hyped, that has me stoked. I'm a fan of single-player content in video games, especially fighters. Compared to other fighters, man, NetherRealm Studios is just constantly giving it to us. I'm so stoked for that. Then again, this is just one section. There's a complete other section with the Warrior Shrine from MK1. So there's two sections, two game modes in this game that we still don't know. So guys, that is all I got for y'all today. I'm so stoked to see what these two game modes are. I don't want to jump the gun and say 100% this is happening or this is happening, because I really don't know. We're basing all this off an image and some tweets, and it's crazy because that's all we have. And these last few days thinking about this, it's been driving me crazy. So anyways, what do you guys think of both of these game modes that have question marks on it? What do you think the Warrior Shrine is? Do you think it's the Crypt? Do you think it's something else? What do you think of the one that's right next to the Towers of Time, the classic towers? Do you think that's maybe Conquest Mode? Do you think that's maybe AI Battle Simulator? Let me know inside the comment section below. If you did enjoy this video though, please take 1 second, drop a like on, of course, subscribe for some more MK11 content. Until next time, been your host, been Dynasty. You guys, please take care, stay safe, and I'll see you guys later. Peace. Combos and your setups, you one of the greatest. You deserve more exposure, man. You underrated. To all the Dynasty haters, promise you'll love them later. Y'all gonna react like he did when he seen the trailer. But hold up, let me hit y'all with a twist. Wait, I'm Sub-Zero. The rap game is the Lin Kuei. You see, I've been a fan of Dynasty for years now. GTA, MK, and Justice. I'm still down. Rapper meets